If it's a spindle gouge, if you're using.
Yes, I'm using a spindle gouge. There's my cutter. There, how's that? I have three spindle gouges, they all kind of have that same cutter. You know, I do a double bevel on it. Well, actually, I do three. I cut here, then I relieve it here, then I pick the cut off the body.
Is that recording?
Yes.
Okay.
So yeah, I use a spindle gouge. Oops, no, I took a big cut out of that, so. It's really possible to start it.
yeah.
even with a small cut, you know, sometimes I'll take it in a hurry, and you take a big cut.
Yeah.
I think that's pretty good.
So you got to refine the outside again?
Yes, I do. Thank you. This will be my dagger, outside dagger rings, and I think that right there looks good. So now I'm going to do an establish where they're going to be. I won't put 38 on again. When they got the length up, they always have two rings. So I'm going to do a hit and a curve ring. So the top ring here will be a little smaller than the bottom. And then we'll do a third ring. To show how the captain ring tool works that can be out.
Here, so I'm going to do a couple of moves in here.
And when I'm done, I put one in the bottom of the base, you know, right there, so it's tied all together. I have my blender tools here. I have, I believe this one is 9,000. This one's 17. And I know that because I'm a guitarist. And I have guitar strings, so they're all measured, telling you what size they are. So, as a matter of fact, I'm going to put all these strings on so anybody wants these when they're ready to leave, they can grab one and make their own library tools. So, but here's a whole bunch of wires. And what the size is listed on. So let's see, I'm going to do the bigger wires on the band's right. And I'm just going to hold it on for a second. And there's my burn. Hold that one on there. There's the burn on that one. And then I'm going to go with my smallest one here. Oh, I knew that was right there. I guess I'm going to do the same size on both of them.
I would put my, I'd get three coats of resin on the inside of this.
which that takes a couple days, because that resin takes about 8 hours to dry. And I would get the sand up to 400, I get my 3 coats of resin in there, and then at that point, I chuck it back up and finish the outside. So then you get that done, and you got something that looks like this. You got a cup with 3 rings, well, I'm going to take that right off eventually. My 2 rings, they're all iron, they're sanded. My inside of my cup has got 3 coats of food soil, the same resin in there. With that in there, you can't really see it in there, but it makes a nice, it does work well for sealing. We can pass this around the room. So now we're here in the finishing of this cup. I always mark when I number one of that, so I can always chuck everything back up to the exact same spot. Okay, let's see how much this has worked in the last 3 days here. I mean, a little bit of work, not too bad. I'll be able to blend it here when I cut that down. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do now is take these rings out. And I'm going to, let's see, let me cut back this a little bit.
Thank you.
Sometimes they'll crack. I don't see any cracks in there either. And if they crack, I put a little glue in them, glue them back together, let them dry. Nobody knows the difference. There you go, Ken. Congratulations on your catch the ring tool. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this away, get it smooth, and I'm going to take some sandpaper out of this, and then use that sandpaper to sand the inside of your plate.
Tape them to hold them on.
Yes, when I get down here, I'm going to tape these out of the way because they are like little finger magnets. Wherever you put your fingers, they go right towards it. You know, they're always whacking into your tools and stuff like that. So I'm going to tape these things and get them out of the way. They sand these bottom sides with 150 and then 320. Or 150 and 220, I'm sorry. 150 and 220. And then that's all the farther I go on the bottom of these rings. The no slip grip, because this actually has got a sticky back on it, and it actually kind of adheres to itself inside this on the back of this stem, so I don't have to worry about coming loose as quickly. And it also lasts longer than a lot of sandpaper.
All right, there's my two rings. So now what I'm going to do is take my sandpaper off here. I'm going to take my rings back there so they're out of the way.
Thank you.
I guess it will be going back up there one more time. Usually when I get this down where I think, oh yeah, that looks pretty thin, I like to walk away and come back and look at it, because it never is as thin as I think it is the first time I cut it. Hang on a bit. Sometimes I get memorized doing this and go too fast. I need my bifocals in here. That was not good. These backing pads? I ordered these from some sandpaper place online. I like them, they're nice.
Vince's, I think, has
them. I think you can get them as good. Well, you can't. They don't have them with this little handle thing on it, Vince's. They have like a backing pad that made you go onto a 5-inch orbital grinder, but. I need that one back.
Oh.
Here, I'll trade it. Do they? I've never seen them there, but
there.
I still got a bad hit there.
Hang
on,
we got it.
This is where I like to determine how big the bottom of my goblet's going to be. And I want it to be the same size, basically, as my widest part of my top of my goblet. So, because I feel if it's roughly the same size or a little bigger, it's a goblet. If the bottom is smaller than the top, it becomes a chalice. You know, so you see a chalice has a small bottom and the top is like twice the size. And then if you get the bottom really small and it won't stand up anymore, it's firewood. That's a joke.
gonna be back. I'm not getting there, okay? I'm not gonna get my money, right? But I know. If I've got like a marbled area in this cup that I'm trying to accentuate, I'll do like a big stand here and then I cut it down and do a really small part going to the top there, just so I can show off some of that wood. So, all right, I think I'm gonna take a little more out of there. A little bit of air. With these ring grips here. Somewhat important. And I'll just go dive in here.
With people who want to do the rose engine,
right?
You want to meet like right over here?